help me sing.
Victory.
Listen.
Come on.
He never told me how he's gonna do it.
Watch out,
now,
watch
out. He never tells me just how he's gonna
fix it.
Come on.
Anyhow, I'm a happy shawty. Till the Lord till the Lord
Lord,
now get happy, shawty.
Worship experience. We pray that you had an amazing week. We are in the month of February. February has a lot going on. February is Black History Month. February is the month of love with Valentine's Day. And then it's also Heart Health Awareness Month as well. And so we have a lot going on in February. And so we're just grateful that you have joined with us to get a word from God today and to celebrate life today, because we are grateful for life. We don't want to take that ever for granted. So welcome to the Forestville New Redeemer Baptist Church live stream worship service. We are again glad that you have joined with us, decided to tune in this morning. We pray that something is said or done that will bless you, encourage you, and keep you pushing forward to what God has called you to. Let us pray. God, I just want to say thank you. God, we thank you for another day of your grace and your mercy. God, just thank you for being God, that you have been faithful to us. You've been kind to your people. God, there is absolutely nobody like you, God. And so we are just grateful this morning. We're overflowed with gratitude, God, and we just want to say thank you, Lord. We could not thank you enough for all that you've done, all that you're doing, God, and all that you're going to do, God, because you have promised, God, to give us abundant life, God, if we continue to seek after you, Lord, God. And so I pray today that somebody that's tuned in this morning, Lord, God, needs something from you, God, and they will receive it today in the name of Jesus, God. Touch the heart of your people. Open their hearts to receive what thus saith the Lord through the word of God. God, I pray that somebody will be encouraged through song. God, someone will be encouraged, God, through whatever is spoken today, Lord God, that you'll do the transformation that needs to be done, God, that your people, God, will be uplifted and encouraged, God, to continue to press forward, to do what you've called us to do, to be a light in this dark world, God. We just thank you in advance, Lord God, for the word that will come forth from our pastor, that it will come forth with power and authority, God, that we will receive it, God, and then go out and tell a dying world, God, that Jesus is the way, God. We just want to say thank you. We love you. We honor you. It's in your son Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Again, amen. Again, we welcome you. If you're joining with us through Facebook, you already know what to do. We've asked you many times to make sure you share this video with your followers, family, and friends. If you, again, just press the arrow that's on the top, you'll be able to share it on your page so that others may see and be blessed by this broadcast. We ask that you also like our Facebook page so you get notified when we have live videos. And again, share this page with your followers, family, and friends. We love to stay connected with you. So if you want to know more about our ministry or simply desire prayer, you can visit our website at www.forestvillenewredeemer.org and click on the tab prayer request, or you can call our church line at 301-736-4488. Someone will respond and connect with you as soon as possible. We have so many things going on at our church, and we're so glad that we're still able to keep pushing forward in the midst of a pandemic. Nothing can stop what God wants to bring forth. And so we have our Saturday church school. That's every Saturday morning, except for the second Saturday of each month. The adults meet every Saturday morning from 11 a.m. to 12 noon. The children, elementary to junior high, meet on Sundays at 6 p.m. And our young adults meet on Sundays at 12 noon. We pray you will join with us and continue to study the Word of God. Every second Sunday of the month is our men's and women's fellowship, where we come together to encourage and uplift each other. And so we pray that you would join us on second Saturdays of the month. We also invite you to join us weekly for our prayer calls on Tuesday at 8 p.m. and also for our Bible studies on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. We are on the move, sharing the love of Christ, and we want you to stay connected with us. At this time, we want to encourage you to sow into our ministry with your tithes and your offerings. Now, there are three ways you can give to our ministry. Number one, you can text Forestville to 77977, or you can visit our website at www.forestvillenewredeemer.org and click on the Giving tab, or you can mail in your giving to our church at 7808 Marlboro Pike, Forestville, Maryland, 20747. We are beyond grateful for your giving, and we pray God continues to bless you and your family. Now, I don't know about you, and I say it every Sunday, I'm excited about the word that will come forth today. I pray that you get to a place where you're excited about the word. The word gets you excited to learn more about what God is saying in his word, that it can apply to your life, and you can use it in your everyday life. Because that's what the word is for, to encourage you to keep moving forward. The Bible is still relevant today as it was back then. And so we pray that you will be encouraged and inspired by the word that will come forth today through our pastor, because he is studying to show himself approved. And he's giving great words that are empowering God's people, to move forward and to do what they've been called to do. So after a musical selection, we will hear from our pastor, Reverend Dr. Nathaniel B. Thomas. Be blessed.
Went down to the River Jordan, where John baptized three. When I walked the devil in hell, says Johnny baptized me. I say, roll, Jordan, roll, roll, Jordan, roll. My soul will rise in heaven, Lord, for the year old Jordan, roll. Well, some say John was a Baptist.
Some say
John was a Jew. But I say John was a preacher, because my Bible says so, too. I say, roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year of Jordan, roll. Hallelujah. Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year of Jordan, roll. Hallelujah.
Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan roll.
Everybody say, roll, Jordan, roll.
Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, thank God for the year when Jordan rolled. Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan rolled. Roll, Jordan, roll. Roll, Jordan, roll. My soul arise in heaven, Lord, for the year when Jordan rolled.
Melanie Griffith was born in Abilene, Texas, and lives in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. She earned a bachelor's degree in human services from Montana State University and a master's degree in social work from Howard University. Griffith's career experience includes working as the vice president for external and governmental affairs with Greater Baden Medical Services, and she currently serves as a member of the Maryland State Senate representing District 25. In 2020, Senator Griffith became the first African-American woman elected as the president pro tempore for the Maryland Senate. Speaker Adrienne A. Jones was born and raised in Baltimore County. She earned a bachelor's degree in psychology from the University of Maryland in Baltimore. She shattered two glass ceilings when she was unanimously elected by the full House of Delegates to serve as the first African American and the first woman speaker of the Maryland House of Delegates in history.
Oh, freedom. Oh, freedom. Oh, freedom over me and before I'll be a slave, I'll be buried in my grave and go home to my Lord and be free. Oh, freedom.
And go home to my Lord and be
Good morning to the Forestville New Redeemer Baptist Church family and to the Forestville live stream broadcast, as well as our Facebook Live, our YouTube, and our telephone conference. We just want to bid you a good morning, for God is so good, and He's truly worthy to be praised. Let us pray together as we go forth in the name of Jesus. Father God in heaven, we come this day to say thank you. We thank you, O God, for another day, a day that we will never see again, but you have allowed us this day. We ask you, O God, to bless this message, O God. Let this message be a message that will penetrate, that will heal, a message that will give inspiration, as well as, O God, put us on a firm foundation. We ask you, O God, that as we go forth, you are to be at the helm of all that's being done. In all of these blessings we ask in your name, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. This morning I want to come out of the text of Mark 2:18 through 22. And it says, and the disciples of John and the Pharisees used to fast. And they came to say unto him, why do the disciples of John and the Pharisees fast, thine disciples now fast not? Verse 19, and Jesus said unto them, can the children of the bride chamber fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they can not fast. Verse 20, but the days will come when the bridegroom shall be taken away from them, and they shall fast in those days. No man seweth a piece of the new cloth on an old garment, else the new piece that filleth it may taketh away from the old, and the rent, amen, the rent is made worth. And no man putteth a new wine into an old bottle, else the new wine does burst the bottles, and the wine is spilled, and the bottles will be marred. But new wine must put into a new bottle. And I want to share with you today, as we look at this scripture, and Jesus said unto them, can the children of the bride chamber fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they cannot fast. And I want to share a thought with you this morning. Why fast? Why fast? Today, you know, fasting is not very popular these days among Christians. Fasting is the willingness to refrain from eating. It's hard to talk about not eating when we have so many fast foods all around us. McDonald's, Burger King, Kentucky Fried Chicken, Popeyes, we name it, we could almost claim it, because we live on fast food. Some may say, do we live to eat, or do we eat to live? Here In a physical context, fasting may refer to the metabolic status of a person who has not eaten overnight, or the metabolic state achieved after completing or a complete digestion and completing a full meal, in digesting that meal. In other words, metabolic is referring to the breakdown of food and the transformation it turns into energy. Mentally fasting is to improve an alterness, a mood. It is to transform our mood and to be subject to our feelings of well-being and improving overall systems from depression. Also, fasting for some has been weight loss. Why fast? When we look at the 18th verse, it says, "And the disciples of John and of the Pharisees used to fast. And they came to say unto him, Why do John's disciples and the Pharisees fast, but your disciples does not fast?" As we examine this text, we will see that he was talking about John the Baptist. And we find here that John the Baptist had two goals, it appears. And we see that one of the goals was to lead people to repentance of their sins. And the second was to prepare them for Christ's coming. John the Baptist's message was a sobering message, so that he and the followers became those who fast. Fasting in both an outward sign of humility and a regret, that's regretting from sin, and an inner dwelling, if you will, in terms of the cleanliness in clearing the mind and keeping the spirit alert. Fasting, if you will, empties the body of food. Repentance empties the life of sin. One commentary said that Jesus' disciples did not need to fast. They didn't need to fast to prepare for his coming. Why? Because he was with them already. Jesus himself fasted 40 days, according to Matthew 4 and 2. Nevertheless, Jesus emphasized fasting with the right motive. Sometimes today we fast for the wrong reasons. The Pharisees, they had a tendency of fasting for the wrong reasons. On the other hand, the Pharisees had a way of fasting twice a week to show others how holy they were. Jesus explained that if people fast only to impress others, they are twisting the purpose of fasting. Why fast this morning, church? Jesus compared himself with a bridegroom. Remember, in this word, the image of the bride is often used for God's people, and the image of a bridegroom is the God whom love us. As we look at here in this scripture, Jesus simply replied, "Do friends of the bridegroom refuse to eat at the wedding?" He didn't need to. Should they be sad? While Jesus and the Pharisees had twisted the purpose of fasting, let us not find ourselves twisting the purpose of fasting. Because the purpose of fasting is being able to get with a real relationship and having a real relationship with God. I can tell you right now that this should be a festive occasion when you fast. It ought to be a festive occasion being with one who loves you. A lot of times when we talk about fasting, it becomes a problem. It becomes a problem because we come with a lot of excuses why I can't fast. We come with a lot of excuses because we have been inundated with a lot of bad habits. We have allowed ourselves to eat in a way that is unpleasing to God. We have allowed ourselves to go forth day in and day out, not honoring the temple that God has blessed us with. Many times it's hard to fast because we have not been honoring God the way we ought to honor God. Why fast? Why fast? Why fast? And no man putteth new wine into an old bottle, else the new wine will spill out and the wineskin becomes ruined. New wine needs a fresh wineskin. My God, needs a fresh wineskin. The Pharisees had become rigid like old wineskin. Sometimes we can become so rigid in our ways that people can't even see God in us because it's all about us as opposed to being about God. But when we fast, we ought to humble ourselves and give ourselves back to God. They could not accept the faith in Jesus when they could not continue or limited by man-made ideas and rules. When we start doing things on our own, our faith goes out of the window. Why does it go out of the window? Because we're leaning on our own understanding. But when we fast and pray, we are turning it all over to the Lord. God is good, church, and God is worthy to be praised. Church, I want you to know that our hearts, what is being suggested in the scripture, that our hearts ought to become like wineskin. Our hearts ought to become not so rigid that it prevents us from accepting the new life of Christ. Because a lot of times we're so stuck in the past that we can't go into the future. Because I want to do it my way, because this is the way it's been. But when we fast, God is looking for us to come with a new attitude. God is looking for us to come with a new thrust. One of the sad things about us when we fast, we have a tendency of saying, "Lord, it took me 20 days to get through this Daniel fast. And then once I fast, I'm glad it's over, because then I go right back to the same thing I was doing all along." But what God is trying to do is to cleanse us from old habits in order to come into a new habit. And let me tell you something, if we've been accustomed of doing things the wrong way for a long time, it becomes a process to be able to change the way we think, to change the way we talk, to change even the way we live and eat. I can tell you why fast. Fasting is a process of working on our minds, working on our hearts, working on our souls to the point that we are ready to make a change in our lives. It's no need. A lot of times folks say, well, look, I'm a diabetic. Look, I'm an asthmatic. Look, I got one sickness after the other. But if we look at the reality why we are sick the way we are, it's because of the past lifestyle that we've been living that has caused the sickness to come upon us, and God wants us to change. Woo! Why fast, church? Why fast? God is looking for a new thing to come out of us. From the pulpit to the door. I can tell you, I'm not telling you to do as I say do. But I'm saying do as what God is saying for all of us to do. Because we all have come short to the glory of God. We ought to come with a new attitude right now, church. Why fast? Why fast? I just want you to know a new attitude of how we care for our physical temples that God has given us. What goes in us have a way of altering our minds. It has a way of altering our thinking, and it has a way of altering our health. Why fast? Why fast? We are to keep our hearts flexible and not become hard-hearted and open to accepting the life change that God is trying to bring into our lives. We got to understand that the truth of Jesus' message is a good one, a wholesome one, a healing one, if we just trust him and allow him to abide. When I look at Psalms 35:13, David says, but as for me, when they were sick, my clothing was sackcloth. I humbled my soul with fasting, and my prayer returned unto my own bosom. In other words, what happened to David? David was praying, but he thought his prayers was for naught. He thought that when he prayed, it bounced off the wall and went nowhere. But when you fast and pray, it teaches us how to be patient. It teaches us the opportunities, what God has for us. It teaches us how to let go and allow God. Why fast, church? Why fast? We got to understand, when I look at Matthew 6:16, Jesus said, when we fast, let us not be like hypocrites, because that's what the Pharisees were. They were hypocrites because they were only fasting to show who they thought they were, how religious they are. I want us to understand, we are not trying to be religious, but we are trying to be in the Spirit of God. And when we are in the Spirit of God, God can use us. I can say it, you know, when we are in the Spirit of God, we don't have to go, as it said in Matthew 6:16, that they came with turn up faces and their countenance was all sad and messed up and their faces all disfigured. I can tell you, when you fast and you're giving it over back to God, you should be able to give it with a smile on your face. You should be able to give it and say, Lord, hear my, use me. Lord, I want you to use me. I want you to change me from my old wicked ways. I want you to give me the health that you want me to have in order for me to do your will, your way. I can tell you right now, we got some other issues, not only physical issues, but we got issues mentally as well. Because a lot of times our diets have a way of messing up our minds. But I can tell you why fast is going not only without food in order to spend time with the Lord, but it's also being able to spend the kind of time with yourself and the Lord. And watch how God will work it out in giving us time to pray, giving us time to be taught, giving us time to become more self-disciplined. Remind us that we can live with a lot less. Some of our minds are so messed up that we just got to buy, and do more buying and still cannot honor God. God wants us to be able to have what he wants us to have and to also share back to him. Why fast? Jesus never condemned fasting, but he did condemn the hypocrisy of the Pharisees. Why fast, church? Jesus is the groomsman, and the church is the bride. That's good news. And once you are married, once you get married, you can't continue to do things the same way you always done it. You can't have that selfish attitude like you always had it, because it was only centered around me, myself, and I. We must be able to be deliberate in making a change if we're gonna allow God to abide in our life, if he's our groomsman and we're the bride. I can tell you, discipline, it means not being self-centered and being selfish. Honest, not disloyal. Willing to give of all the old ways. Willing to follow and let God abide in your life. I can tell you right now, to avoid emotional sickness, this week we're going to go into fasting and praying. I don't know about you, but if it's something that you want to change in your life, be ready to fast. Some of us say, well, I can't fast because of my health. Well, I want you to know God gave me another ingredient here to share today. Because for those who are not ready to deal with the food, you can deal with some of your spending habits. You can begin to deal with your finances. Not only dealing with your finances, to begin to deal, if you will, with your electronic entertainment. Because sometimes that electronic entertainment gets ahead of the Lord. Because you can't get God in your life because you're out in another sphere. And also being able to have that personal fast. I can tell you, God can make ways out of no way. But we got to understand that he didn't mean that he was against fasting according to this text. But what was being said and emphasized that the fact that he was the master, he is the master of our lives. And I can tell you right now, if we allow him to be the master of our lives, we don't have any problems letting go and allowing God. Isn't he good today? Isn't God worthy to be praised? Isn't God one who is the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore? I can tell you, when you let go and allow God to abide, watch how when praises go up, blessings come down. Oh, God is good, you all. And I'm going to tell you, you may not always get what you want, but God will give you everything that you need. Why fast? Fast is a commitment. Fast is saying, God, I'm giving myself back to you. Use me, shape me, mold me, make me, guide me. Great God from Zion. Why fast? Fast is not a rudiment. It's not just something to do, but you got to have it on the inside with humility, being able to humble yourself, humble myself, humble ourselves back to God. Why fast, church? God is able. Wherever there may be sickness, yes, it's a process. Because in order to come into the sickness that many of us now have, it didn't just happen overnight. And we're not going to be able to get over it overnight. But through fasting and praying, God has given us an opportunity to get it right. And at the end of the fast, don't go back to your old wicked ways. Leave them potato chips alone. Leave all that white rice alone. Leave that white bread alone. If we're able to make it without the white bread, the white rice, watch how our bodies will begin to change. God is saying, when we fast, I'm looking for a change in your life. Because when a change comes, not only of your body, but a change will come in your attitude. Your change will come the way you think. A change will come the way you walk. A change will come the way you deliver whatever it is that God has for you to deliver. And let me tell you something. When a change comes through fasting, we're able to do God's will, God's way. God can't use no coward soldier. But in order to be a strong soldier, you got to be in shape to get on the battlefield. That's why we got to be in shape on a daily basis, getting ourselves ready, because the enemy is out there to rob, to steal, and to kill God's people. But we got to be able to let go and allow God. None of us can go on a battlefield ear prepared. None of us can fight a war out of shape. But when we in shape, when the enemy comes at us, God has a way of giving us the power, the strength to be able to shake him off. Get him off of me. But when we are all down and out, we find ourselves being overtaken by the satanic spirits that is out to rob, to steal, and to kill us. I can tell you right now, it takes time. Fasting and praying takes time, gives us time to get it right. I heard somebody said not long ago that it's never too late until God calls you home. But while you're here, we ought to make a change from some of our old habits and do it God's way. Some of us say, I just can't help eating all that fried chicken. I'm guilty. Yes, I am. I'm guilty, y'all. I'm telling the truth and shaming the devil. Yes, I'm guilty, but God wants me to do better. And God wants you to do better, too. Some of us drink too much. Some of us smoke too much. Some of us even lie too much. God is looking for a new spirit, a new way. Why fast? Fast gives an opportunity to repent and turn away from our wicked ways. Turn away from self-destruction. Turn away and turn back to God in letting him do what God do. Let his anointing of the oil run from the top of our heads to the entirety of our bodies and watch what God will do. I can tell you why fast. God has given us an opportunity. When I think about Paul and Silas, when they were in the Philippian jail, one was praying and the other was singing. And I can tell you, get a song in your voice. Get a song in your repertoire. Because I can tell you, when you sing every now and then and keep on praying, I can tell you God is hearing your cry. I can tell you Paul and Silas was praying and singing. But the word said at midnight, great God from Zion, how many of us right now are at a midnight situation? But because they fast and prayed, the God shook the jail cell and opened it up for freedom. We need freedom right now from the tears that comes at us, from the strife that is all around us. God shook the jail cell and freed them from the hostilities that they were confronted with. Why fast, church? Trust God. God will do it. I say God will do it. God will do it if you just let him abide in your life. He's able, church, great God from Zion. He's able to do it. Are you willing to allow him to come in? Don't just fast because the pastor asks you to fast. Don't just fast because it's a popular thing to do. But fast because I want a relationship with you, Lord. I want to be better than yesterday, Lord. God, cleanse me. Shape me and mold me to what you want me to be and what you want me to become. I know that you're able. I know that you can clean me up. I know that you can straighten me out. I know you'll give me another chance. My faith is saying, God, I know that you can do anything but fail. As I continue to look at this, why fast? Why fast? Have you ever asked God for something? Because you know, when you're fasting, you're tearing. Ah, you're finding yourself in a posture where things are just not happening instantaneously. But you're waiting. You're waiting patiently and watch how God will abide. When I think about the pills, when I think about the pills that I'm going to be sending each of you, I want you to be able to take a pill a day. Be able to take a pill on fasting. be able to take a pill on honor, be able to take a pill on strength, overcoming, peace, blessed, prayer, endurance, wait, study, time, vocation. Somebody is looking for a job right now. Somebody is looking for employment right now. But just be patient, the vocation is going to come. Somebody is needing some more money. Watch, pray for the treasure. But then when you pray for the treasure, get that pill of praise. And watch through the praise, get the pill of health. When you get the pill of health, then you're able to keep on going and worship. Get the pill of faith. Get that pill of steadfastness and being unmovable. Then comes the pill of healing. And let me tell you, on the 20th day, I don't know about you, but I'm looking for a day of jubilee. I'm looking for a day of saying, thank you, Lord. You've been mighty good. You have blessed. You blessed me when I couldn't see my blessing. You blessed me coming out. You blessed me coming in, going in. God, you're able. Oh, I can tell you right now, I want you to take on some of those pills in the name of Jesus and to be able to look at the other types of fasting that I'm going to send you and watch how God is going to bless you. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we come right now in the name of Jesus to say thank you. Thank you for what you've done and what you're still doing. We recognize, oh God, that you let us know that we can't pour old wine, new wine in an old bottle, but we got to come fresh. In other words, oh God, we are trying to become a new temple. We're trying to come with a new attitude. God, we're trying to come with a new walk and not allow the old walk to overcome us. For we're looking for new wine. We're looking for a new way of life that you're going to take us and how you're going to carry us. Lead us right now, dear Lord, for you're mighty good. You're worthy to be praised. I thank you for what you've been, dear God. There's somebody out there right now, God, who don't know you in the pardon of their sins. God, there's somebody that feels like a motherless child, a long way from home. But God, I know, no matter how far it seems, you are right here, right now, by our side. Bless right now in the name of Jesus. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child, a long ways from the home, a long ways from a home. Oh Lord, sometimes I feel like I'm almost gone. Oh, sometimes I feel like I'm almost gone. I said, sometimes I feel like I'm almost gone. A long ways from the home. sometimes I feel like the motherless child. Oh, sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. A long ways from the home, a long ways from home. God bless you. I can tell you, yes, we feel sometimes like a motherless child. But thank God that the God that we serve is the bridegroom. He's the one that will take care of the bride. Even when you feel that you're all alone, know that God is right there by your side. But we got to learn how to let go, fast and pray, and allow God to abide in our lives. Isn't it good? Isn't God worthy to be praised? Well, I don't know about you, but in spite of sometimes feeling like a motherless child, feeling all alone, God is right there with us. And when we fast with a smile on our face, fast because I want to. God, I want your blessings. God, I want a change in my life. God, I want to do everything that you have ordained me to be and to become. I want to be everything of the purpose that you have already ordained in my life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, he's able. Yes, he's able. Yes, he's worthy. Yes, yes, he is. And yes, he will. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. As I close out, I just want to share with you that we have on our prayer, amen, in terms of fasting and praying through March 1 through the 26th, the directions are here. And the theme is out of pandemic darkness into God's marvelous light. And you're going to see all the pills that I have shared with you in this document. Amen. And there's scriptures that is connected. And I also have a disclaimer here that those of you who are diabetics or experiencing medical problems, please consult with your doctors prior to participating in this fast. But guess what? It's not going to stop you from fasting, because I'm sending you another document. And the other document is some things that can turn behaviors around. Financial fast. And when I think about a financial fast, I think about looking at reframing from non-emergency or non-essential spending. Because sometimes we spend frivolously. And to begin to get off of all those credit cards and debit cards that you have no other options as to in a self-paid parking garage. Come with a new attitude. Not a whole lot of eating out, my Lord. And then here I go back to the Daniel fast. And let me tell you all the Daniel fast is doing here, so that there won't be no misunderstanding. The Daniel fast is saying remove meats, sweets, alcohol from our diet. And check out, you'll be able to check this out, because let's face it, some of the stuff that we're eating right now we don't need to be eating. Some of the stuff that we are taking into the temple that God has given us, we have no business taking it in. And yet it's killing us every day, because our taste buds has gotten into a sinful state that we can't help ourselves. But through fasting and praying, God will change our taste buds, that we will come with a new attitude. And let me tell you something. If you just stop eating the bad stuff, you're on your way. The process has already begun. When you pray, say, God, help me stay away from unwanted kinds of foods. Help me. The doctor has already told me what I got to do. Now, Lord, help me to overcome the bad habits that I have acquired and do it another way. And I'm going to tell you, you're on your way. And then when the fast is over, hopefully and prayerfully, you'll begin to pick up good habits at the end of the fast that will take you on. And don't go back to the old habits, but come with a new. Because you can't pour new wine in an old bottle. Because what Jesus was saying, that bottle will leak. It will leak, y'all. We don't need a leak in our building. Because every time sickness comes upon us, there's a leak in the building. Come on, church, we can do this. Every last one of us can do it. And then to begin to train our children how to eat and how to live. In the name of Jesus, I thank God for each and every one of you. And God is still in the blessing business. Let us remember Aunt May. Let us remember Mother Cruz, Brother Philip, and Sister Jackie, whose brother passed this past week. And we just thank God for Deacon Ferguson. I saw him on yesterday. And I'm going to tell you, I thank God for Deacon Bonds. You did a super job. We had over 4,000 pounds of clothing that we were able to give away. Over 4,000 pounds, and many of those clothes still had tags on them. So they didn't get junk. They got good stuff. And we just say thank you so very much. And thank all the volunteers that were out there and were able to give of themselves. I thank you for the media ministry. I thank you for what you're doing. I thank you, oh God, for the Christian education, Sunday school, and all of what they're doing. There are more classes now being added, and we're reaching other age groups. We just say thank you right now. Because when you fast and pray, I've been fasting before this time of fasting, but I know what the power of fasting will do. I just say to you, trust God and watch what he'll do. Until next Sunday, may God continue to bless you. Don't forget about Wednesday at 7 o'clock, our Bible study at the 7 o'clock hour. But until next Sunday, we'll see you at the same time, in the same place. And may God bless you, because we walk by faith, not by sight. Because upon this rock, the word said, upon this rock, I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. May God bless you, and have a good day. God bless. I forgot to tell them.